He ain't been seen in two days.
Your John will be fine. I mean, he may be as dumb as rocks and as dull as rusted iron, but that ain't changing because he got caught in some snowstorm.
What's happened to you, Arthur? Three young, healthy women want you to take them a ride, and you're worried about house chores. Let's go.
Fair enough. You got me. Come on in.
I can't believe we're going to see civilization. Feels like weeks since we did.
Yeah, Valentine.
Very embodiment of civilization.
I went to Blackwater looking for you, gentlemen. You're not very popular there, it seems.
We left a lot of money there.
And young Sean, it seems.
Sean, you found him?
Yes, I have. He's being held by some bounty hunters, trying to see how much money the government will pay them.
You want to go hunting?
What are you hunting? An elephant?
I wish. No, I saw a huge bear, one of the biggest I ever saw. I reckon nearly 1,000 pounds.
My God, but you need me to come with you.
Of course. Let's go.
Where are we heading exactly?
Up near the Dakota River. Might take a day or two.
I could do with a break from this place.
Oh, me too. It's been a rough couple of weeks. You need anything?
I don't think so. I got all I need.
Let's go then. So you still ain't replaced Boadicea?
Nah, I miss her. She was quite a horse. This one's okay, but ain't no Boadicea.
I've been meaning to offload this big Shire horse for a while now, unruly bastard.
Where'd you get him?
Some big, loudmouth bastard tried to rob me and was out riding, so I... Well, you know how it is.
I see.
Let's take him to Valentine. It's on the way. Sort of. There's a decent dealer there. We'll unload him. You could buy yourself a new horse. Put your saddle on them. Let's get going.
Okay. But I do kind of like this horse.
There's nothing wrong with two horses. And the stables always have the best ones.
Well, I guess you're right. Just get this adjusted, boy.
This is going to be fun, Arthur.
You won't throw me?
No, he's an angel. If I'm near him.
Nasty little look in his eyes.
Oh, don't be rude about this magnificent creature.
Easy, big feller.
All right, let's head into town. No bar fights, please. I heard about that.
I'll do my best.
We're heading out. Might be gone a couple of days. They got a good range of horse tack at the Valentine Stables. Some beautiful saddles. I used to have a real nice one.
Yeah, what happened to that?
Got stolen outside that saloon in Deer Creek.
Ah, I remember now. Just about. That turned into a long day.
Yes. Remember? Mac went crazy, threatened to kill the whole town. And Davey was passed out so cold we left him there, came back in the next day, and he woke up, started right back drinking again.
I'll miss those boys.
Jenny, too. She had some spark, that girl.
It must be pretty hard on Lenny. You could tell he was sweet on her.
Well, Lenny and Jenny could never have worked. That's like Arthur and Martha, or Bill and Phil.
Yeah, maybe you're right. Does feel a bit like our luck died with them, too.
Nonsense. We'll be all right. Just need some money to get back on our feet.
I hope so. You found a way to offload those Cornwall bonds yet?
Not yet. They're still very hot. Need to be done right. I have a couple of leads I'm looking into. Stables are just up ahead.
Keith, pork,
go sell that big brute and buy yourself a horse.
Okay.
I'm going off to the general store. Get a few things to lure that bear out with. Meet you back here in a bit.
Hey, how can I help you?
I'm in the market for a new horse. Something strong and fast.
Yeah, well, you're in the right place. I got some beauties in at the moment. Yeah. And what about this one here? Yeah, you looking to sell?
I sure you.
You got papers?
No. No papers.
Well, of course, that's gonna affect what I can pay. But your luck's in. I got a fella who's been looking for a decent workhorse like this for a while. He'll pay a good price. Otherwise, I can always stable him here for you. Here, take a look. All right, partner. You got yourself a deal. And a fine new horse.
I hope so.
Well, I don't sell anything other than good animals. You have my word on that. All right, let's see. Here are your papers. And on me, a new grooming brush. And some treats.
Appreciate it.
Yeah. All right, you. You treat this fella well. I know he's gonna look after you just fine.
Interesting choice. How much did you pay for that thing?
Not that much.
Okay, well, with some good care, you should be able to make something of it. All right, let's get going. We got quite a ride ahead of us.
Lead the way. So, what's this lake we're heading for?
It's called O'Cray's Run, up in the mountains east of Cumberland Falls. I just hope I can remember how to get there.
Back into the mountains? I sure didn't figure on that.
But this time, we're doing the chasing. So how are things with you and John?
Fine.
Ain't it about time you let it go now?
It was a year, Hosea. He ditched us for a goddamn year.
I've spoken to him many times. He knows he did wrong. He just wants to put it behind him.
I'm sure he does. Running off on that kid is one thing, but there's code, and he knows that. He ain't Trelawney. Dutch and you pretty much raised him.
I know. But it's done. Has been for a while now.
Nobody else would have been welcomed back that easy after that long, and you know it.
Maybe. But please don't you put that to the test. Okay, I think we need to head right up here. Yes, I remember this place. Moonstone Pond. We're going the right way. That's the lake there. Good. We made it. Let's loop around the other side. Yep!
I should really be heading back over to Great Plains to see about Sean.
It's bounty hunters who've got him?
So Trelawney says. Javier and Charles have gone with him to scope it out.
Pretty dangerous going anywhere near Blackwater.
Right, but if he's alive, we gotta try.
Of course.
Before, you know.
Yeah. And obliterated them with a shotgun, if I remember right. Good job. All right. It's getting late. Reckon we should camp here.
Sure.
Well, then, you get us set up.
I'm famished.
Cook that rabbit, then. They're delicious on an open fire like this.
Fine by me. You want some of this?
No, I'm fine. I don't like eating this late.
Okay. After all that.
All right. Well, we better get some rest. I want to be up at first light to find this monster.
He better be worth all this drama.
Morning, Arthur. You ready?
Give me a minute.
Coffee?
Sure.
There you go.
So, what's your plan?
Well, we'll see if we can track him, but we might need to lay bait to draw him out. Bears like fish, obviously, but they also have a sweet tooth. A lot of fellas bait, then shoot from the trees, but I prefer to hunt on the ground. More dangerous. But we'll have a much better chance of getting a good shot in. And if he bolts, we can start right off after him. Can you mix up this bait for me while I finish packing this up? Fish, berries. Tie it up in that rag when you're done.
I hope you know what you're talking about.
I grew up in the mountains, Arthur. I was virtually weaned on bear meat. Hurry up so we get going.
Okay, I think I got this done.
Good. Pack up and we'll get going. Okay. Let's go. We'll try our luck down by the water. That's where I saw him last.
Okay.
How's that horse treating you?
So far, so good.
You know, I was in this area with Bessie years ago.
Really? I didn't know that. I imagine you still miss her.
Every day.
Did you two ever think about getting out of the life?
We did briefly. You don't remember? Guess you were still young. Didn't last long. I drifted back into it. She understood. She knew what I was.
I remember you not being around for a while, but well, things were looser back then.
Truth is, there's never really any getting out. And staying in, it's hard. You know that. But Bessie and I made it work. Why? You thinking about getting out?
Me? No, of course not.
Listen, if Dutch's grand plans work, and we can make enough money to go someplace new, really new, maybe we can all have a new start. Anyway, for now, let's try and chase ourselves a bear, shall we? Let's look by the water here, see if he's been fishing again recently. Look for tracks, dung, bones, any sign of him.
Well, there's some paw marks here, Hosea. They sure look big enough.
Good. Let's hope it's him. Can you tell which way he went?
This way. The tracks go into those trees. Wait a minute. Something on the ground here.
Half-eaten fish here. Must have been left by our friend, I reckon.
Come on, see if there's anything else. There's shit here. Watch your step.
Looks real fresh. Reckon he's gotta be close.
Let's keep going. Like the trail ends here. We lost him?
For now. A little optimism, Arthur.
Well, what do you think?
I think we split up and each look.
Either that or we could place bait here.
That could work. Which do you think?
Best bait here.
Fine by me. Now we wait.
£1,000, you say?
More or less. Big scar down his face. Hey, did that bait look okay to you?
I think so. You're the expert.
Ready with your gun there?
I'm good. You okay? You seem nervous.
So do you. I'm fine. Let's just take a look at that bait.
Sure.
Come on.
We only just said it, Jose.
I know, but we need to do this right. Give me a hand here. Got your knife? Shit. Easy. No, it's too close.
You're fine, old man.
Of course I'm fine. It's nothing. Nothing at all.
Thank you, I think. That was fun.
You know what, Arthur Morgan? I'm a little old and beaten up to be after the biggest game. You can have this.
What is it?
It's a map. A man in a bar gave it to me. Well, I stole it from him, but that's another story. He said it told him where to find some real big animals.
Thank you.
It's a pleasure. You saved my life, Arthur. I think I'm going back to camp to lick my wounds. You coming, or you gonna track that monster?
I'm gonna stick around here for a while.
I'll see you back at camp. Yeah!
Go sir. Try to remember what really happened at Sylvia's Saloon back in 76.
Just a lot of bunk, Plato. It's just a lot of bunk.
It's not bunk, Mr. Calloway, sir.
Who's your friend there?
This is Jim Boy Calloway. The Jim Boy Calloway.
Who?
The gunslinger. Fastest left-handed draw that ever drew breath. He once killed 14 men in a fight at Lucy Hollow.
What are you waiting for?
How do you mean?
Well, I reckon right now, kill him yourself.
I don't want to kill him. I want to deify him. He's a god. I'm trying to write his biography.
How's that going?
I think I prefer the duel. Either I'd kill him and be able to be Baltimore's finest ever gunslinger, or he'd kill me, and I could be set free from ever having to speak to him again.
Well, you're starting to understand something very important.
What's that?
The joys of gunslinging. It's win-win, freedom or glory.
That's brilliant. I'm gonna write that down, if I may.
Be my guest.
What's your name?
I don't have a name.
But you are a gunslinger.
Not really. I mean, folks who need shooting, I try and shoot in the back. All that other stuff, it's, well, bunk.
But you fought duels.
Once upon a time, I may have.
And you ain't interested in fame?
I don't think so.
Strange. But you like fortune.
I need money, sure.
Okay, then forgive me, mister, if I seem a little desperate. I am a little desperate. This book, I've got to make a thing of it, and... Well, there's a whole list of gunfighters. Legends, every last one. Emmett Granger. Flacco Hernandez. Billy Midnight. Black Bell.
Never heard of them.
Maybe you can go and speak to them. Ask them about Calloway. Any of them get uppity, shoot them. I can't believe I just said that, but...
You want me to go and find some... sad, deluded fools like him. Ask if he was the greatest, and then if they get uppity, shoot him.
Does sound a lot worse than it did in my head.
How much you paying?
Well, a lot. Half the proceeds of the book, if you help me get it written.
I'll see what I can do.
Ha! Oh, get photos.
Okay.
And there are notes on the back of those portraits that should lead you to him.
I'll see what I can find out.
I imagine we'll be stuck here upon your return. Here are some other flop house.
Yeah. Thanks. How's it going?
Hey, who's that? You're in the wrong camp, stranger.
You don't want to die for Hernandez, do you? Take me to him. I got some questions to ask.
Okay, if it's just questions. He's up in the cabin. Watch it, people. Stranger in the camp. He ain't going to be here long.
Flacco Hernandez, I don't want any trouble. I'm here to speak with you about Boy Calloway. I'm unarmed.
Well, King Gallagher.
I just want to talk about Boy Calloway.
Sure. Here's your message.
Thank you.
Let's go, girl. Yeah.
Ah!
okay, girl.